What up, what up, what up, what up? What's cracking, everybody? Welcome back to Boo TV. Thank you for clicking on the video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Let's talk about the topic today, which has to do with the NBA All-Star Game. Now, I could have waited till, you know, the All-Star week came up to do this video, but I couldn't, man, because this... I cannot watch the NBA All-Star Game anymore. In fact, I really stopped watching it and stopped getting excited about it a couple of years ago. there was a time, right? People say, you know, when people criticize the All-Star Game, people give pushback and say, well, they never played defense in the All-Star Game. That is not true. That is not true. That is not true at all. There was a time where defense was played at the All-Star Game, some level of defense from beginning to end. Now, I'm not saying they were playing playoff level defense the whole entire game, but they were playing playoff level defense for the entirety of the fourth quarter and at least regular season level defense, or maybe a little less than that for the majority of the game, whereas now there's absolutely no defense going on. Now, before I get into this, I will say over the last 2 years or 3 years, I don't know how long it's been, when they implemented the new All-Star Game rules and format to try to make it more competitive by winning each quarter, that did help with the competitiveness a little bit. But it's still not what it used to be. Like I said, there was a point in time where the players really took pride in the event that is the All-Star Game. The players back then were much more competitive and really took it as an opportunity to show what they were capable of and do things that you may not be allowed to do so much in a game. Showcase your one-on-one skills. Call people out, specifically play one-on-one against certain players while still having fun in the process and being competitive. Back in the day, and I think one of the reasons where it really started going downhill was when they got rid of East versus West, because they said it's not competitive anymore because the West is just that much better, and then they started assigning team captains and all the players mixed. I don't like that. Now, it was already going to shit before that, but it really went to shit when they implemented that. There's a point in time where, even though after Michael Jordan retired is when the Western Conference really started becoming more dominant, pretty much right after Mike retired, the East became insignificant. And there was still a lot of pride taken from the Western Conference players and the Eastern Conference players to show the world, we have the better players, we have the better conference. And because the Western Conference was generally considered so much better and so much deeper than the Eastern Conference, the Eastern Conference players took that personal going into the All-Star Game, because they were like, hey, all we keep hearing is about how we're not as good as the West. Well, we're gonna come out here and we're gonna show you that we can compete with these guys. That was a thing, dude. That was a thing. And people weren't just running around giving everybody open dunks. And then another thing is that back in the day, even the early to mid 2000s, and maybe a little bit into the late 2010s, the first decade of the 2000s, rather, there was more defense, far more defense being played, and there was more premier defensive players in the league at the time. So you had players making All-Star games where they were primarily known for their defense and not their offense. So when these players would get in the game, they're not there trying to show you, now, I can't really do any flashy dunks or flashy layups, and I don't really have flashy handles, and I don't have a whole lot of skill, like an all-star level skill strictly on the offensive end, but I'm primarily here for my defense because I'm known for my defense, And when I get in that damn game for the All-Star game, I'm trying to block every goddamn thing you put up there, bro. I'm trying to block your dunks. I'm trying to block your layups. I'm trying to block your hook shots. I'm trying to get steals. I'm going to put a body on you. At least I'm going to put a body on you. Players like Dikembe Mutombo and Alonzo Mourning were making All-Star games as primarily being known as defensive players. And they were out there protecting the paint and blocking everything that came their way. That was, you don't believe me, you could go watch the video footage. They said, I'm here for my defense, and I'm going to show you why I'm here for my defense. I remember Kobe saying the 2001 All-Star game, because nobody was really trying to go into the paint that much because Mutombo was trying to eat everything. Kobe said, they ain't trying to climb Mount Mutombo today. They don't want to climb Mount Mutombo. He's like, I'm going to climb my Mount Mutombo. I'm going to climb my Mount Mutombo. That's the Mamba mentality. And even Kobe, more than anybody in those All-Star games, Kobe relished it. Kobe cherished the opportunity to get on the floor with the greatest players in the world and showcase his talents and prove why his conference was better. As the ultimate competitor, Kobe was. So everybody knew what time it was, especially Kobe. Kobe treated those All-Star games like playoff games. I kid you not. Especially when he was matched up against a player that was wildly considered a rival. You check, go look at the footage. Whenever he was matched up with T-Mac, he was on his body. Any player, you name him. D-Wade, Bron, whatever. And Kobe really started getting agitated in his later years, even before his Achilles. He started getting agitated at the lack of competitiveness at the All-Star game. And to some degree, he started taking a backseat in the All-Star game to give the younger players more time. But he was also frustrated that people weren't competing anymore like they used to. And I remember, I think it might have been his last All-Star game. He said, hey, I remember they interviewed him before the game. He said, hey, I just really hope people come out here and compete and, really put it all out on the floor. He said that because he knows what it's been the last X amount of years. These players don't compete anymore, man. And growing up, I used to love waiting. I can't wait till All-Star Weekend. I can't wait to see the greatest players on the court actually go head-to-head, actually compete, and try to show who's the better conference. That was a thing. I can't wait to see these players match up against each other. And it was exciting. It was an actual event where these people are competing. And you didn't know who was going to win. Like I said, the Western Conference was lopsided. I usually expected the West to win all the time. But it didn't always happen that way. You know what I mean? And then nowadays, the things, the dunks people do, the dribbling exhibition people do, players do, the crossovers, the behind the backs, the passes, they don't even look good. They don't look good. They don't look exciting. They don't look cool because nobody's playing defense on them. They're just letting them blow past them. A crossover doesn't look the same when a player is guarding you versus when a player is just sagging off you and letting you do what you want to do and players are letting you blow by. It doesn't look the same. That crossover isn't the same crossover. You're not really crossing anybody up there. They're not playing defense on you. Same thing with the dunks. Dunks don't look as exciting when they're clearing the lane for you and letting you dunk in a game versus when you don't know when a dunk is coming because there's defenders around and someone jumps up and explodes. It's not the same. It's definitely not the same. It doesn't look as good. Versus, somebody playing defense versus somebody not playing defense. I can't get excited over a Kyrie Irving crossover on somebody when they're not guarding them versus him actually crossing them over and they're trying to play defense on them. It's not the same, man. And for that reason, nobody's forcing me to watch. I know that. I don't have to watch it. And like I said, I really don't get up for the All-Star games anymore. And like I said, I did watch the one, Kobe's last one, because Kobe's my favorite player. And then, the change in the format, because I wanted to see how much it did improve the All-Star game. And, while I think it did improve it somewhat from a competitive standpoint, I really do miss the times of East versus West, because, I mean, that's what it was all about, man. And I really hope they go back to East versus West at some point. And you can still do the draft or whatever, if people really like the draft setting or whatever. I don't really care for it. It's whatever to me. I've never watched a single NBA All-Star draft ever. I don't know why. Doesn't interest me. But I really hope one day they can get back to that. Where I really was just like, I'm done with the All-Star games. I don't remember what year it was, but there was an All-Star game where Giannis Antetokounmpo was coming in on a fast break, and Steph Curry literally just laid down on the floor, jokingly. Are you effing serious? I said, you know what? I'm done with this. This isn't even fun. This ain't fun. This is stupid. I can't watch this. As a person that likes to watch people compete. And I'm not saying I expected Steph Curry to try to block or dunk Giannis Antetokounmpo. I would have been perfectly fine if he would have just stood there or just stepped out of the way. Or at least met him, ran up to him and met him before he even got to the rim. But Steph Curry literally just laid down on the floor like this. Like, ooh. I'm like, bro, what is this? What am I watching? That was really the nail in the coffin for me. And the best All-Star game I've ever seen was the 2001 All-Star game in Washington, D.C., where everybody was talking about the West going to smack them. And the West was smacking them for most of that game. Smacking them. And there was no doubt in my mind that the West wasn't going to win. And then, sure enough, the Eastern Conference fought really hard, led by Allen Iverson and Stephon Marbury. And it went down to, like, the final couple minutes of that game was an absolute showdown. Iverson hitting big buckets. I remember Marbury hit back-to-back threes. Kobe on the opposite end hitting clutch basket after clutch basket with Dikembe Mutombo jumping in his face. And then it came down to the final shot, and the Western Conference had the ball. And Kobe drove. He dished off. I want to say to Tim Duncan for a little bunny at the rim, and I think Duncan missed it. And then even KG or Chris Webber, one of them, had a chance. I think it was C-Web, had a chance to put it back in at the buzzer and tipped it and go or something like that. It was the greatest All-Star game I've ever seen. And that's for somebody that was rooting for the Western Conference and the Western Conference lost. That's hands down the greatest All-Star game I've ever seen. And they competed back then, bro. The mentality of the players back then is just so much different. And then everybody's talking about, and nowadays, you guys get like a whole week, maybe even more than a week. You get at least a whole week off for the All-Star break these days. And you're sitting here complaining about rest for one All-Star game, and you get all these other days off. You don't have to compete in other festivities. The league is soft now. As a whole, the league is soft. And, you know, also, and I just miss being excited for the All-Star game for some solid competition, for bragging rights between conferences, between players. The good old days. So, actually, what we're going to do, we're going to watch the video that pissed me off of Steph Curry laying on the floor. And then we're going to watch the last couple minutes of the 2001 All-Star game together. All right, here is the video of Steph Curry laying on the floor by Tom Bomb on YouTube.
20 points for Giannis, first time All-Star.
This was the 2017 All-Star game.
And comes up with a steal.
Look at this. What am I watching right now, bro?
Curry just looking to get out of the way.
Yeah, smart decision there by Steph.
Maybe I get it. I might be that old guy. Maybe sometimes I get off my lawn. I try not to be. But come on, man. That's not even. Man, players of old would have never did something like this.
Right here, Steph Curry. What is this? I'm not going to be in anyone's poster. Oh, what if.
All right, here we have the last 2 minutes, real time, uncut. So it's actually going to be about 9 minutes long. But the last 2 minutes of the 2001 All-Star game that, in my opinion, was the best All-Star game.
his teammates. Somebody's got to help me in here.
First of all, look at that score. Look at that score. 104 and 100. Look at that score. 104 to 103. That tells you that it was much more competitive and players actually played defense back then. Nowadays, you're getting 100 points at halftime at the All-Star game now. Like, I'm not even lying. You're getting 100 or damn near 100 at halftime. All right, let's get into it.
West is led by as many as 21. Nice pass. Carter, try to get it back.
J.K. Marbury got a body on him at half court. Marbury got a body on him at half court on J.K.
Allen Iverson with 13 of his 23 points in the fourth quarter.
You can see I ain't making this shit up. I would never.
Jim comes from nowhere, tries to tightrope along that sideline. Marv, you said it so perfectly a while ago as he steps out of bounds. The other night in the Garden, he was having a horrible shooting night. Hit, I think, two or three shots late to win that game. He will keep attacking you.
T-Mac on KG. Look at that defense, bro.
Iverson on the run. Iverson gets it off. Calls the foul.
Look at that defense, bro. Look at that. Look at the joy these players play with. Mutombo out there ready to eat everything. No, no, no. No, no, no. No, no, no.
The East has heard all year long. The West is better. The West is deeper. The West has got all the big players. You know what? Right now, it's a tie game. Iverson has a chance to.
Like I said, the West was kicking their ass all game.
So this is a big game for them. They want to show.
They really did come back.
Iverson, 82% free throw shooter. So the East takes a one-point lead. A minute 35 remaining in the fourth quarter.
Trying to force Kobe left.
Bryant.
Pump fake.
Bryant able to hit. Marbury chased him down, but Bryant still hit. And the West up by one. Stephon Marbury handling against Jason Kidd. And wants a timeout.
Little strategy here now. Larry Brown's taking a
who that? Was that Jerry Stackhouse? Jerry Stackhouse.
Make sure they get a good shot.
Was that Stackhouse?
Allen Iverson has been the story for the East. 15 of his 25 in the fourth quarter.
Well, great players make great plays. Kobe Bryant going off the screen of Tim Duncan, pulls up, and he knows he cannot get to the basket because there is Mount Mutombo. He's been there the entire fourth period, and that little medium-range jump shot gives his team once again a one-point lead.
Now to a minute 18 remaining in the fourth quarter.
They have Sheed.
The East, 105.
Great defensive player, Rasheed Wallace.
Eastern Conference ball.
Also a great offensive player as well.
Carter for three. Vince Carter having his difficulties down the stretch.
So he's got to play with Kevin Garnett with a hand in his face. Kevin Garnett 6'11 with that long reach, so he's not going to get any easy shots.
Bryant, yes. Kobe Bryant with two clutch buckets. He now has 17. The West leads by three. Marbury for three, yes.
I love it. I love this.
And Kobe Bryant wants the ball once again. He's made the last two baskets. They double him and force him to give it up. Jason Kidd might have to shoot the ball here.
Look at this. Doubling Kobe in the All-Star game. Mutombo jumping out at him.
Oh, that is unbelievable. Mutombo ran out at him. Three unbelievable shots in a row here by Kobe
Black
Bryant.
Mamba. Look, man. Look, man. When have you seen people throwing double teams at a player in an All-Star game? That shows you who the hell Kobe Bryant is. And the level of competitiveness, man. Look, Mutombo was all over that, dog. Kobe is the... He makes the toughest shots I've ever seen of anybody ever
Kobe
to play this game.
Wants the ball once again.
His ability to hit shots is... It's unreal.
Force him to give it up. Jason Kidd might have to shoot.
Going back for a double team.
Is just leaving him wide open.
Bryant.
Oh, that is unbelievable. Mutombo ran out at him. Three unbelievable shots in a row here by Kobe Bryant.
A stirring finish to this 50th NBA All-Star game.
Come get that. Marbury.
Marbury for three.
Go.
Stephon Marbury has given the East a one
The last 6 points for the West. Here's the another double. They have a foul to give. They already know what time it is. They knew what Kobe trying to do. 3 second differential between the game clock and the shot. Split the defense, but they took the foul. See, they're actually, when have you seen that? When have you seen that as well? That they're actually taking fouls as time is running out because they had a foul to give in an all-star game. In an all-star game. Come on, man. Come on, man.
Shooting, clutch shooting. Kobe Bryant with the outside jump shot. Marbury comes back and one-ups him with the three. This once again ties the game. Kobe again with another answer. This time, Mutombo comes flying at him, gets a hand up. He really can't even see the basket, and again knocks it down. And Marbury comes back, spectacular shooting.
Step back. Marbury steps back. Got the Starberries on. Where are those Starberries?
10.9 seconds remaining.
Well, still 10 to 9 tenths seconds remaining in this fourth quarter, but here are the results of the NBA.com polling. For
that's back when you actually had to go on the website and vote. And see, there's only 94,000. Today, you have a million because of Twitter, voting on Twitter. You have to get on your computer, on your dial-up, NBA.com. Let me vote for the MVP. Boy, times have changed.
On the floor, it'll be interesting to see if Iverson runs off of him, goes to Kobe, forces Kobe to pass, and maybe make Jason Kidd take the shot.
All right, here's Kidd. The East up by one. Down to five. Marbury guarding Bryant. Down to three. Marbury trying to get to Bryant. Duncan came up short, and it's over. The East comes from 21 down.
21 down.
To defeat the West, they outscore the West 41-21 in the fourth.
Look at the pride. Look how much this means to them.
Mark, that's one of the best All-Star games I've ever seen. Just the big plays, getting back in the game. And you know what, Mutombo?
Look at this. This is an All-Star game, man. MVP,
but he gave his team a chance to win.
Look at Kobe. He's pissed. That's how much it meant to Kobe. He ain't happy. He's a competitor. At an All-Star game, he wanted to win.
Mutombo, and then here's Vince Carter on the rotation, coming over, getting a piece of Duncan's shot. And the East is very, very excited. Down 21, they come back and get the win.
Whoever thought he had that, I thought that was good too when I was watching it live.
Here's the last opportunity by Duncan. Weber had a crack at it, not able to hit.
Vince, big defensive play there. Vince, big defensive play there.
22 rebounds, three block shots.
22 rebounds and three block shots. 22 rebounds and three block shots in this version of an All-Star game with less possessions and defense. Tell me I'm making this up. 22 rebounds and three. Like I said, you have players in there that were showcasing what they can do on the defensive end. That's why they're there. And you could just see how happy the Eastern Conference was. And then specifically Kobe Bryant, how pissed off he wasn't happy, man. He's a competitor. He wants to win more than anything. It ain't like that no more, man. I miss some days. So, you know, for that reason, I really pass on the All-Star game these days. It's not exciting for me anymore because I'm a person that likes to see competition. And you already have the best players in the world out there, and they're good enough to still create phenomenal plays even with players defending them. I think it's disrespectful to not go out there and perform and show the world what you can do on both ends of the floor. I think it's a sign of respect for you to guard me and me to do my best against you. That's just me, though, as a competitor. Anyway, tell me what you think about it. What's your favorite All-Star game? How do you feel about the All-Star game nowadays? Do you like it? Do you not like it? Do you like the new format that they rolled out recently with the quarter-by-quarter victory? Like I said, let me know what you think in general. Love to hear your opinion, all right? Thank you for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next one. We out, baby.